Well, welcome everybody to Valentine's Day's Board of Public Works and Safety meeting. Roll call, please.
Mr. Ray? Mr. Markgraff?
Here.
Mr. Long?
Here.
Any conflict of interest statements?
No.
No. Approval of the minutes for February 7th, 2019.
I make a motion to approve the minutes of February 7th, 2019.
And I'll concur. Item A, bid opening, Third District Local Street Project, 164th Place and Alexander Avenue, McCook Avenue to Kennedy Avenue, and 165th Street to Alley North of 164th Place. There are four bids. The first bid is from Reeve Riley Construction Company, 7500 West 5th Avenue. Gary. We have the bid proposal. It is, would this be? Okay. Their total bid is for $1,306,769.46. We have the bid bond. We have Form 96, as well as and also their non-collusion affidavit. Okay. Second bid, Dyer Construction Company, 1716 Sheffield Avenue, Dyer, Indiana. The bid cost is $1,268,041.79. Yes, I will, because I think I stumbled. $1,268,041.79. Have the bid bond. The non-collusion affidavit, and also the Form 96. Bid number three, Walsh and Kelly, 1700 East Main Street, Griffith, Indiana. Proposal. With a cost of $1,238,275.61. We have a bid bond. Form 96. As well as their non-collusion affidavit. final bid is from Grimmer Construction, 2619 Main Street, Highland, Indiana. Bid proposal, cost being $1,259,368.46. Have the bid bond. The non-collusion affidavit. And Form 96, okay. That concludes the bid opening for item A. I would entertain a recommendation to submit these to the engineering department for tabulation and recommendation.
I'll make that recommendation.
And I'll concur. Item B, quote recommendation for the second district drainage improvement project received from Nice Engineering. Please find at the enclosed quote. Okay, Nice Engineering requested quotes for this project from J.J. Newell, Walsh and Kelly and Rex Construction. The engineer's opinion for the cost of the project is $32,847. J.J. Newell Concrete quote was in the amount of $34,992.50. All right. His opinion that second in district Indiana Street drainage improvement project should be awarded to the lowest responsible quoter, J.J. Newell Concrete, for the amount of $34,992.50. I'll entertain a recommendation to approve the request.
Okay, I'll make a recommendation to approve the request from Nice Engineering.
And I'll concur. Item C, correspondence received from Second District Councilman Pete Torres requesting $34,992.50 of gaming funds be allocated to make improvements on Indiana Street under the Columbia Avenue overpass. This has been signed by the councilman as well as the mayor.
Make a recommendation to approve Councilman Torres' request.
And I'll concur. Item D, quote recommendation for the First District Warwick Avenue Drainage Improvement Project received from Nice Engineering. First District Warwick Avenue Drainage Improvement Project. The engineer's opinion of cost for the project is $23,379.95. B&D Sewers bid was in the amount of $26,748.50. Is the opinion First District Warwick Avenue Drainage Improvement Project should be awarded to the lowest responsive and responsible bidder, B&D Sewer, in the amount of $26,748.50. This recommendation is made at the discretion of the Hammond Board of Public Works and Safety. I'll entertain a recommendation.
I'll make that recommendation to
and
accept,
concur.
To accept it.
And I'll concur. Item E. Correspondence received from First District Councilman Mark Kelwinski requesting $26,748.50 of gaming funds be allocated for sewer drainage improvements on the 1600 block of Warwick Avenue. This request has been signed by the councilman as well as the mayor.
I make a recommendation to accept Councilman Kelwinski's request.
And I'll concur. Item F. Correspondence received from Goff Incorporated requesting closure of Highland Street and Eaton Street between Calumet Avenue and Soul Avenue for construction on Hammond High School.
Does it say how long?
Let's see.
3 days.
They're basically just tying in their sewers, okay. And there's a couple day closure, and there's a detour enclosed in that.
Are they estimating the time they're going to start?
I believe one was a week and a half, which is a deep sewer on Eaton, 2 weeks. And I believe the other one's 3 days, maybe. 2 days.
Forward that to streets and the police department then?
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Are they going to do this simultaneously? Both at the same time?
No.
Okay.
Because the
It doesn't specify, so it just says one's gonna take 3 days and one roughly 2 weeks is what.
Correct. One's on the north side, Eaton Street, and one's on the south side, which is Highland. So basically, they're gonna finish one, come to the other side, and have the detour going around.
Okay.
Okay. Then I'm gonna make a recommendation to forward it to the police department and street department for approval.
And I'll concur. Thank you. Item G. Updated Hammond Police Department lockout waive and release. General order 19-01 received from the Hammond Police Department.
The Hammond Police Department used to do lock, if somebody would lock themselves out of their car, this isn't, and then the police would go over and assist back in the days when it was just a Slim Jim or a coat hanger. Now everything's completely different. It's a completely new procedure. And what we're gonna do is the city of Hammond is going to perform this service. Now this doesn't include like an emergency, something like a kid's locked in the car and it's 90 degrees out. That's, but if somebody's just inconvenienced and they sign a waiver saying that they waive any damage that could possibly occur to their inside door mechanisms, then the city of Hammond has a kit now to open up the car. It's a completely different procedure on newer cars. And then, but they have to sign the waiver. So basically this is just a procedure saying if we're going to do a lockout, it has to follow the guidelines, which includes them signing a waiver. If they don't sign the waiver, we don't assist, unless of course it's an emergency.
So this is filled out by PD?
Yes, and then signed by the person that is requesting to help with help getting in their car.
Okay. I'll make the recommendation to approve the, I'm guessing it's a new form?
It's a new form.
Okay.
And I'll make that recommendation, especially since it pulls at my heartstrings.
And I'll concur.
I could have used that a month ago, that's great.
Item H, correspondence received from Fire Chief Jeffrey Smith requesting approval to continue using Comcast for internet connections for all fire stations. Acknowledgement, I would too, and this one tugs at my heartstrings, brother. I'll submit.
I'll make a recommendation to accept Chief Smith's request.
And I'm gonna concur with that. Thank you. Item I, hearing on property located at 1933 Roosevelt Drive.
Is anybody present on this? Hi, are you Mr. Youngheim?
Yes.
Do you have the agreement?
I dropped it off at the law department.
When? Oh, you have it? Okay. Just for the board's edification, this is a demolition property that was set for November the 29th, and then it got continued, and then it was continued again. This is a property that has a couple of different addresses. It's the old Bekaiza property, and it goes by 1933 Caroline, a.k.a. 605 Roosevelt, a.k.a. 605 and a half Roosevelt, a.k.a. 1933 Roosevelt. It's over there. The issue is one of the properties is damaged, and one of the properties is gone except for a foundation. The damage was as a result of a fire. And so we do have a new owner who has signed the rehab agreement, which involves pulling out the foundation that's left over from the fire and then rehabbing the house that was burned. And do you have a timetable to start on this?
We're gonna begin right away as soon as the permits are pulled.
Okay. Because this burned down in May, and of course we're getting a lot of complaints from the neighbors.
So the house was removed, and then...
Well, we're getting complaints from the neighbors about the view of the burned up back of the house.
Yeah, that'll all be pulled out and filled in.
So, and then I'm sure in the spring when everybody's outside is when they're gonna start calling and complaining about it, because that's the way these things work. Everybody's inside right now, but as soon as everybody's outside, there'll be a cacophony of complaints about this property. So I would ask that the board please approve the agreement. I'm gonna leave it up to code enforcement. We have not actually yet entered the order because we had an attorney enter on this matter and we set it over. I'll leave it up to the inspections department if they want the board to enter an order to demolish in case the work doesn't start to proceed according to schedule.
I would like to have that order entered if we should, could, please. Considering timeframe, situation of the demolition not being completely finished, I want to make sure that that is going to be done, and if not, then we'll go to order.
So you're saying that the property currently is under a order to demolish?
No, it was set for, this was noticed up, Mr. Youngheim received notice of this back on November, well, November 9th is when it was mailed, so some probably a week or so after that. And up until this point in time, which is February the 14th, there's been no improvements to the property. Removing the foundation or even picking up, cutting the weeds, picking up the garbage. So our concern is that if, we've had since November, December, January, February, nothing's happened yet. If we don't enter a demolition order, the fear is that nothing's going to continue to happen because we won't have a hammered hold over it. We just have a rehab agreement. So Mr. Youngheim's, of course, free to say whatever he would like. But he is no stranger to the rehabilitation process, and we've been through this before with him.
Right, so this is our sixth project here in Hammond that we've removed from the demolition list and has completed the project. So I don't see any need in doing that, but it's the board's pleasure.
I'm sure Kelly would be able to testify as to how the previous six projects, the ease of which the city had in getting the work done according to schedule.
Standard policy procedure, we entered order to affirm the demolition. If they're going to rehab and progress is happening, we won't demolish. But if we do not enter that order and progress does not happen, we're going to have to start all over. Having an order is leverage for us to make sure the work is being done and being done properly.
Sir, I'm sure you understand that, right? If you're waiting for permits and you're going to start immediately anyway, this won't even affect you. If you don't, then obviously we have to do what we have to do.
Well, there'll be notifications, I'm assuming, if this was to happen, correct?
Well, I would think as long as there's good communication with Mr. Kearney here, it probably won't happen. As long as there's good communication. As soon as communication stops, that's when things start getting a little murky.
If I may, I'd like to ask Mr. Youngheim to get through the county and get this under one address, because all it does is add confusion to everyone. If I have contractors coming in for an address that we don't have in our system, that we don't recognize the property as, it's just going to add more confusion to everybody, including the order to affirm.
And I am in the process of getting that resurveyed and replatted for clarification from Cratchit, I think it's surveyors.
So you currently do not know what the address is, actually?
Well, it's as she stated.
A lot of things?
Yeah.
It's four different addresses, which we use a key number, so when we do the numbers, we use a key number.
There's also been a vacated easement there. That's confused the thing too. So we're in the process of getting that all replatted and then staked, so that the survey's got to be stake surveyed done, and the ground's frozen right now. So I'm assuming that's why he's dragging his feet.
Okay. Well, my recommendation is going to be to enter the demolition order as requested.
And I'm going to concur.
Thank you.
Still gives you opportunity.
And we're going to approve the rehab that was presented.
I'll make that recommendation also. Sorry.
And I'll concur with that as well. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. We've already posted the bond on that, too.
Yes, I think we got a copy. Thank you. Okay. Item J, notice of violation hearing on property located at 7332 Oakdale Avenue.
Bill Luter is the inspector on this, but there is an attorney, Jonathan Peterson, who has contacted me, represents the owner, and I don't know why he's not here, because there was a court date on the 31st of January, which was during the polar vortex. So he may have gotten the dates confused. And I would just ask if we could set this over till next week, Thursday. I can send him an email and let him know that the hearing before the Board of Works is set. I had discussed with him a global resolution, which is basically where the owner would comply with the building department's request, then we would terminate this action. So it would probably do us a lot more good to set it over 1 week than to try to do it today and then have him argue to set it aside.
Okay, I'll make a recommendation to set over the hearing to February 21st, 2019.
And I'll concur with that. Rental registration hearing on property located at 4835 Calumet Avenue.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
You might remember this was the case that actually started in July where there was an appeal for one unit for 5 years. And then upon the determination, the owner notified the building department that it was actually 2 units. Myself and Jaime were in there last week. We inspected the property. The owner is now willing to convert the house back to a single family home. So we're asking that the late fees be waived and she be charged 2 units for the last 5 years with no late fee. Because she was actually renting out 2 units, it just wasn't registered as so.
Two units, 5 years?
Yes.
$5 a year?
Yes.
I don't know, because we're into 14, that was $80, right?
That's what I thought, but so,
tell me what the 5 years are right now, what are they gonna be? Let's just go back, 19, 18, what?
It would be for 18, 17, 16, 15, and 14.
Okay, all right, we'll have just, yeah, so 14 is $80 per unit, is that correct?
Okay. You're right.
Okay. My recommendation then is to waive the late fees and then charge them $80 for 2014 for both units and $5 for each unit the other 4 years.
Correct.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'll concur.
We'll have to figure this out. Yeah. Let's see.
$90, $100.
5 years for 2 units. Yeah, we'll figure it out. She's not here, so.
No,
nicely done, Mr. Law. Item L. Bid reaward letters received from Mr. Kelly Kearney, Chief of Inspections for property located at 4735 Holman Avenue, 6518 Parrish Avenue, 6910 through 12 Calumet Avenue, 18 Elizabeth Street, 7222 Jackson Avenue, 7526 Linden Avenue, 7532 Linden Avenue, 7546 Linden Avenue, 6927 McCook Avenue, garage only, 7449 Parrish Avenue, 1258 Sherman Street, and 972 Wilcox Street.
JM is the second lowest bidder on all these properties.
And we are doing this as a result of
RSR was the lowest bidder. Unable to perform.
Okay.
Who was the second highest?
JM.
JM.
Okay.
I guess if I would have read this, I would have known that.
Awarding the bid to JM then?
Yes.
Okay. My recommendation is to award the bid to JM on those properties.
Well, I see in here, Mr. Kearney, says acting contracting.
For what address?
Unless this is, maybe I jumped the gun here. Hold on.
Yeah, I think that's a different
this
one.
This is L.
Yeah, it's a different one.
What did I do? Oh, I'm sorry. 2 pages. Jeez, my bad. You're right, JM Industrial Services. Okay. Recommendation?
Yeah, I
okay, mean. And I'll concur with that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, item M. License agreement renewal for Porter's Apparel, Inc., 4510, 4524, 4532, and 4536 Holman Avenue, and its representative, August Mack Environmental. Chris, I'm guessing this is what something environmental agreement.
Yeah, this is for HM to monitor groundwater testing.
Yeah, okay.
I honestly thought Porter's Apparel got bought out by the railroad, but apparently it didn't.
Okay.
Yeah. So we're accepting.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm making a recommendation to accept the license agreement renewal from Porter's.
And I'll concur. Yes, from Novak.
Okay.
So is this one. Item N, license agreement renewal for Remediation Management Services Company, Roosevelt Street and White Oak Avenue, and its representative, the Antia Group. This appears to be the same type of licensing agreement for my environmental services for the properties that were mentioned.
Correct, it's for monitoring.
Okay.
Okay, I'll make a recommendation to accept that license agreement renewal also.
And I'll concur. Item O, amusement device listing for the week of February 11th, 2019.
Make a recommendation to approve the amusement device listings.
And I'll concur. Item P, correspondence received from Third District Councilman Anthony Higgs requesting the removal of two dead trees and debris in the parkway of 910 Ames Street.
I assume Mr. Prieto has got a copy of that request. We will double check the address, make sure what we're dealing with.
Forward it to Parks Department?
Okay. All right.
Okay, I'm going to make a recommendation to forward Councilman Higgs' request to the Parks Department.
And I'll concur.
Thanks, Kelly.
Item Q. Correspondence received from Mr. Jeffrey L. Colby, President Hammond Alum Cats, requesting the 5800 block of Madison Avenue be closed Sunday, July 7th, 2019 from 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. for an all-city, all-class reunion tailgate-style barbecue with a DJ.
I mean, forwarding that to the police department, the streets?
And environmental.
Okay. Okay. I'm going to make a recommendation to forward that request to the police department, the street department, and environmental.
And I'll concur. Item R, receipt of notice to owners of affected property located at 7900 through 50 Cabela Drive and 6110 Calumet Avenue.
There's a proposal to build a little, what do they call it, a micro hospital or mini hospital or a small little hospital, and the city of Hammond is a property owner, and so this is the notification for that project, as we are an adjoining property owner. I'm not sure if the city supports or doesn't support the program, but it is our notice under statute because of the proposed use. So we can just acknowledge it and take no further action, or we could table it for next week if you want to.
No, we'll acknowledge receipt of the notification of the properties. Item S, correspondence received requesting a rental registration hearing. March 14th.
Okay, I'm going to make a recommendation to set that hearing for March 14th, 2019.
And I'll concur. Okay, matters from other board members. I do have one. It's from the police department. Disciplinary action, and I'll entertain a recommendation to accept the police assistant chief's correspondence.
And I'll make that recommendation.
I'll concur.
I don't have anything else, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Vice President. Matters from other department heads or their representatives? New business?
Yeah.
Old business? Meeting open to the public? Mr. Duncan, anything for the record? Jason, nothing?
Okay, I'll make a recommendation to to end the meeting.
I'll concur. Meeting adjourned.